Assalamualaikum and good day dear student. So now let's discuss on the second subtopic under Ransch kata, second order Ransch kata method, which is midpoint method. Alright, so previously we have done with Hyun methods. So now we move to another methods, which is midpoint rule methods. Alright, so we will look at what is the improvement or what is the difference in between these two methods. Alright, however, both are categorized under RK2 method. Alright, so do remember, this is the general form of our RK2 methods. Okay, so now for the case of midpoint, alright, the weightage for A2 is equal to 1. Okay, so from here, when A2 equal to 1, so we may obtain A1 equal to 1 minus 1, so A1 0. Alright, then from here, since A2 equal to 1, so we may have P1 equal to half. Similar to this, Q1 1. Since A2 equal to 1, therefore Q1 1 equal to half. Okay, so by plugging back into the general RK2 here, so we may have here is 0, okay, here is 1. And then we substitute the value for these two constants here, okay, where both is half here. Therefore, we may have the general midpoint formula in this form. Okay, so later on, we will calculate or approximate our function y at the point xi plus 1. It's given by this formula here, midpoint yi plus k2 times h. Okay, even though we don't have the k1 in this formula, but we still need to calculate our first slope k1 because we need this value to be substituted here in the calculation of our k2 here. So you may see here, both point here, when you calculate your k2, is defined at the midpoint, means that a half from the starting value. Okay, so that's why we call this formula as midpoint method formula. Okay, so next we will look in terms of graphical view. Okay, students, so you may see here, okay, we have two figures here. The first one we define as predictor, and then the second one is corrector. Okay, so basically corrector is the formula that we use to correct or to give a better approximate value from the calculation of predictor. Okay, so in midpoint formula, later on, step number one, we will start by calculating our first slope. Okay, k1 at the point f at xi yi. Okay, it means that we calculate here. Okay, the point, the slope at this point here. All right, so we will calculate our first k1 here. And then step number two, we will calculate our second slope. But this time, we find the value in between. Okay, it's not it's a half from your step size. Okay, so this is your step size, and then we find the slope at the point x is half from your total step size. Okay, then we have xi plus half here. So at the point xi plus 1 over 2 times with your step size, okay, and then y1 plus k1 time with your half of your step size. All right, so means that we may find the value here, okay, the second slope here. All right, k2. Okay, and then after that, from this we will improve the extrapolate or the slope here in order to get the new approximate function, okay, yi plus 1, alright, by using midpoint formula, which is by using the previous value, yi, and then plus with your second slope, and then time with your step size, okay. So you may refer here, what we did in the corrector here means the value that we calculate here by using a midpoint formula. Alright, okay, so this is the idea about midpoint, a formula. So later on, we will look at example. And then we may see, is it a midpoint better than Hume? Or the other way around? Or both are give equivalent accuracy? Okay, so we will discuss later in the next video. Thank you.